Hi, I'm Srinivas Yerramalli. I'm a PhD student at the MHI Department of Electrical Engineering at USC. I'm working on wireless communication problems. In specific, I'm working on the problem of underwater acoustic communications. Underwater acoustic communications are different because they typically use sound for signaling instead of radio waves, because radio waves do not propagate very well in water. The use of sound causes several fundamental different characteristics to underwater signaling as compared to, say, cellular signaling or typical radio signaling. And this is, my research is to basically exploit the properties of sound and water to try to come up with better point-to-point links and better network designs for underwater communications. I've also worked on the problem of cooperation in wireless networks and also on the design of a flexible Wi-Fi system for use in in-flight entertainment and so on. But I'll not talk about this today. So underwater communications has several civilian and military applications. For example, the Navy is interested in trying to send commands to a submarine, or the submarine wants to control an autonomous vehicle, or it wants to control a torpedo that it has fired, and so on. Or for example, you are government and you want to find out underwater events such as whether a tsunami has happened or whether an earthquake has happened, and you would want to get information in real time. Or suppose you want to monitor the oceans for the health and try to determine system parameters and so on and so forth. So underwater communications and a deployed network will really help in such kind of scenarios. So let's see what are the challenges of underwater communications. The primary challenge comes from the fact that you are using acoustic signaling instead of radio signaling, which causes the following problems. One, acoustic signaling has very less bandwidth, which means that you can signal at very slow rates. In addition, if you have motion in water, for example, if you are an UAV trying to communicate to some other moving object, you have a lot of Doppler, and the Doppler manifests itself in the following way. For example, the first UAV sends out the signal, and the second UAV, when it receives it, will receive multiple copies of the signal, each scaled at a different rate, which means that the packet size that is incoming into the receiver will be different for the three different paths. This causes what is known as time-varying interference, and this is one of the biggest problems that we try to solve in an underwater communication system. So because of this, different scales of the signal that arrive in water, you have the following signaling problem. In a typical wireless system, signaling is arithmetically uniform, which means that you scale at frequency fc, you signal at a frequency fc plus delta f, and so on and so forth. But in an underwater signaling system, the signal is geometric, which means it's fc, it's a times fc, it's a squared times fc, and so on and forth. As you can see, this is completely different from what you typically see in wireless, and that is why this is fundamentally so challenging. So we have worked on several problems related to this, and we have primarily worked on the complete design of a receiver. I worked on Doppler correction systems, where you basically pre-process the signal in such a way to compensate for the Doppler, and which simplifies the processing for subsequent blocks. Then we have worked on the design of a channel estimation algorithm, which will basically try to give you an estimate of this different scaled version of the signal. We try to exploit the properties of the underwater channel when we try to do this. And finally, we have come up with a new data detection scheme that is supposed to significantly improve data detection. So you can see in the picture here that the amount of interference a typical scheme will cancel is banded around D symbols in the main diagonal, but the scheme which we have come up with completely eliminates interference except for a few small bands that is left out. So as you can see, this the equalizer design which we proposed, and this exploits properties of the underwater channel significantly better. We have filed a patent application for this. If you are interested in knowing more about my work, please contact me at my email. Thank you very much.